Cisco SD-WAN VS Mark installation and configuration process is exactly the same as for VBAND controller. Install VS Mark, install certificate for VS Mark, and finally create DTLS tunnel between VS Mark with VBAND and VManage controller. DTLS tunnel will be used to transfer management and control traffic between controllers. The main task of VSMart is to announce routing information between WAN routers via OMP protocol or Overlay Management Protocol. This protocol is similar to BGP, but it is used in SD-WAN infrastructure. VSMart also handles key and policy exchange used for IPsec tunnels between WAN routers. All of these control traffic are negotiated securely via DTLS tunnel between VSMart and WAN routers. Data traffic itself between WAN routers are transmitted via IPsec tunnel. Just to review, VSMart is connected to both out-of-band management network and also internet transport. IP address 192.168.252 is the address of out-of-band management, and 192.168.152 is the address of interface connected to internet transport. 11152 is the IP address that will be configured as system IP in VSMart controller. We start by importing VSMart OVF like what we did for VManage and VBAN controller. The name of the machine is VSMart. We need two network adapters, the first adapter for out-of-band management and the second adapter to be connected to internet transport. By default, as you see, VSMart has one network adapter, so I will add another network adapter. Edit setting, add Ethernet adapter. In my VSphere environment, both out-of-band management network and internet transport are in the same port group, both external. After adding the second adapter, now I can power on the machine. Now let's review the configuration and then configure VSMart controller. As you can see, the first adapter ETH0 is used as out-of-band management and the second adapter ETH1 is used to connect to internet transport. By default, username and password are admin. The password is changed to raiko-co.com like what we did in VManage and VBAN controller. System configuration is the same as VManage and VBAN. Hostname, system IP, site ID, organization name, VBAN IP address, and NTP will be configured in VSMart controller. The details of each of these commands are already explained in VManage installation process. Then we configure VPN 0 and VPN 512. VPN 512 is used as management VRF and VPN 0 as default VRF. Interface ETH0 is configured in VPN 512 with IP address 192.168.252. Interface ETH1 is configured inside VPN 0 with IP address 192.168.152. Default route is configured in VPN 0 with gateway 192.168.1.1. Default route can also be configured in VPN 512. What I have not configured since my management client is directly connected to out-of-band network. Now let's configure. Open Console. Admin, Admin, New Password, Royco-Code.com, again, Royco-Code.com, Config-T, System, Hostname, vSmart, System IP, 11152, site ID 100, domain ID 1, organization name Royco, vbond IP address 192.168.1.51, clock time zone. آسیا تهران NTP server 37 156 28 13 prefer VPN 0 show configuration to double check the configuration then commit. And now VPN 0 and VPN 512 must be configured. VPN 0 to show running config VPN 0. By default ETH 0 is inside VPN 0, so no interface ETH 0. IP route default 192.168.1.1 interface ETH 1 IP address 192.168.1.52 SH24 no shutdown and commit. Now VPN 512 interface ETH0 for out of band management IP address 192.168.252/24 no shutdown and then commit. Let's check the connectivity. It is okay. Now we can connect with SSH. Admin Royco-Code.com with show interface tab we can check the IP address ETH1 for internet transport ETH0 for management and system ID as look back the all of them are up to make sure we can ping internet for example ping Okay, now through vManage interface, we can add vSmart controller in vManage environment. We have to install certificate and then create DTLS tunnel from VSmart with other controllers. First, We have to add VS Mode controller in VManage in devices, controllers, add controller, VS Mode, 192.168.1.52, username admin, and password Royco-code.com. CSR will be created in a few minutes, so we'll ignore it in this step. When VSMart is added in VManage, CA certificate is automatically copied into VSMart controller. Let's check it. Show certificate. Root CA include Royco. As you see, CA certificate is already copied into VSMart controller. Now we can request an install certificate for VSMart. Certificate controllers VSMart. Generate CSR, copy, request, advanced request, Estivana certificate template, submit, download, change the name of certificate to VSMart, copy it. In Estevan training folder, and then install certificate. As you see, certificate is installed successfully. You can see that certificate is installed, but not yet in synchronized state. We need to create DTLS tunnels from VSMart with VManage and VBond so they can be synchronized. DTLS tunnel is already created in VManage and VBond. Now it must be created in VSMart controller. Tunnel is created over internet transport. ETH1 is in default VRF and connected to internet transport. We create tunnel interface and allow all services in tunnel interface. Let's do it. VPN 0 interface ETH. One tunnel interface allow service all and then commit. Now we have to check in VSMart to make sure that DTLS tunnel with VBond and VManage comes up with command show control connections. Two DTLS tunnel must be created with VBond and one DTLS tunnel with VManage. So all of them are up, as you can see here. Also, you can check in dashboard and main dashboard. As you can see, VSMart is added to the list. And the color is green, it means it's activated and okay. In configuration, devices, controllers, you should see that the VSMart is in sync state and the search controller is added to SD-WAN infrastructure.